So welcome to the first video of Unit 1, One-Dimensional Motion. In this video, we're going to talk about the difference between distance and displacement. Before we get into the lecture, let's discuss some important physics terms. Whenever you see this triangle, this is the Greek symbol delta. Delta means the change in something. This could be the change in speed or the change in height. Whenever you see these absolute value signs, you may have learned in your math class that any number within these brackets will always come out positive. But what you're actually doing is taking the magnitude of that number. For instance, if I asked you what was the magnitude of -6, the answer would be 6. Lastly, understand that right and up are considered positive and left and down are considered negative. Now let's get into the lecture. Distance is defined as the total length an object travels. We do not take into consideration the direction the object travels. Since we only take into account the magnitude, we consider distance as a scalar quantity. Displacement is defined as the change in an object's position. We do take into consideration the direction the object travels. Since we take into consideration the direction as well as the magnitude, we consider displacement as a vector quantity. One way we can find our displacement is subtracting our final position with our initial position. Let's say we have a toy truck that started at an initial position of 0, that traveled 15 meters to the right, 5 meters down, and another 15 meters to the left, and we were asked to solve for the toy truck's distance and displacement. Let's solve for our distance first. Remember, distance is defined as the total length an object has traveled. So our toy truck traveled 15 meters, then it traveled 5 meters, then it traveled 15 more meters. Now you may be wondering, why aren't these two values negative since we went down and to the left? Because remember, when we're dealing with distance, we only care about the magnitude of the numbers. So we have 15 meters plus 5 meters plus 15 more meters, giving us a total of 35 meters for our distance. Now let's solve for our displacement. Displacement is defined as a change in position of an object. So our toy truck traveled 15 meters to the right, so that's a positive 15 meters. Then it traveled 5 meters down, so that's a negative 5 meters. Then it traveled 15 more meters to the left, which is a negative 15 meters. This gives us a total of negative 5 meters. Now, the second way we can solve this is using the formula delta x equals our final position minus our initial position. Well, we know our initial position is at 0. And we know the distance between here is 5 meters. So our final position must be negative 5 meters. So let's plug in these values. So our final position is negative 5 meters, minus our initial position, which is 0 meters, giving us a total of negative 5 meters. So either method works, it's your preference which one you want to choose. Let's look at another example. Let's say our toy truck travels 8 meters to the left, and we were asked to solve for the toy truck's distance and displacement. Well, when we're dealing with distance, we only take into consideration the magnitude. So in this case, our toy truck's distance traveled is 8 meters. When we're dealing with displacement, we do have to take into consideration the direction the object has traveled. So since our toy truck's traveling to the left, the toy truck's displacement is negative 8 meters. Okay, students, let's do one last example. Let's say our toy truck traveled 10 meters to the right, then 4 meters to the left, and we're asked to solve for its distance and displacement. When we're dealing with distance, we only take into consideration the magnitude. So our toy truck traveled 10 meters, then it traveled 4 more meters. This gives a total of 14 meters. When we're dealing with displacement, we have to take into consideration the direction as well as the magnitude. So our toy truck traveled 10 meters to the right, so that's a positive 10 meters. Then it traveled 4 meters to the left, that's a negative 4 meters. This gives a total of 6 meters for our displacement. Another way we can do it is using the formula delta x equals our final position minus our initial position. So our final position is here, which is 6 meters, and our initial position is 0. So we plug in the values. 6 minus 0 gives us our displacement, which is 6 meters. So in recap, distance is the total length an object travels, whereas displacement is the change in position of an object. Right and up are considered as positive, and left and down are considered negative. Thank you for watching this video and hope to see you next time.